You are listening to KLRN Radio, where liberty and reason still reign.
Hi, I'm Jay Farner, CEO of Quicken Loans, America's largest mortgage lender. Spring will be here soon, so if buying a new home is on your to-do list, right now is the time to call Quicken Loans. Learn about which mortgage options make sense for you and get a jump on your competition. With our exclusive Rate Shield approval, the low rate you lock today is protected for up to 90 days while you shop for your new home. With a Rate Shield approval, if rates go up, your low rate stays locked. But if rates go down, you get that new, even lower rate. Either way, you win. Talk to us today at 800-QUICKEN or go to rocketmortgage.com to take advantage. Here's another great reason to work with us. For a record 9 years in a row, J.D. Power has ranked Quicken Loans highest in the nation in customer satisfaction for primary mortgage origination. Again, to lock in today's low mortgage interest rate and get the security of our exclusive Rate Shield approval, call us today at 800-QUICKEN or go to rocketmortgage.com.
For J.D. Power award information, visit jdpower.com. Rate Shield approval only valid on certain 30-year fixed-rate loans. Call for cost information and conditions. Equal housing lender. License in all 50 states. NMLS number 3030.
Hi, welcome to this Subway ad for the new Sesame Ginger Glazed Chicken Signature Wrap. How would you like it?
I'll take a...
Sports announcer at home?
Yeah, how'd you...
We just know.
My wife picks up the new signature wrap. It's got double the rotisserie-style chicken mixed with a sesame ginger glaze. She appears annoyed at me, but she shrugs it off. Those sweet and savory flavors are calling her name. She lifts the wrap and... She takes the bite! Incredible! And now she's closing the door on my... Subway, make it what you want.
Limited time only at participating restaurants. Double meat basement, average 6-inch sub.
I'm Little Teapot, short and stout.
Here is my handle and here is my spout.
No, Dad, like this. When I get all steamed up, then I shout, tip me over and
tip pour me out.
This is WWE superstar Roman Reigns. It only takes a moment to make a moment. Take time to be a dad today.
Visit fatherhood.gov, brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
KLRN Radio has advertising rates available. We have rates to fit almost any budget. Contact us at advertising@klrnradio.com.
They need the touchdown. Kellen throws across the middle. Touchdown, Aggies! Courtney Davis!
Good evening, everybody. Howdy, and welcome to a podcast divided, or pod divided, rather. I'm one of your hosts tonight, Aggie, and with me tonight, joining me is my fabulous producer, Lou. Say hi.
Princess producer. I'm sorry. I think I was might have been muted.
That's Princess producer, Lou. How are you doing, hon?
I'm doing pretty good tonight. It's been a crazy week, has it not?
It has been rather insane. I'm kind of glad it's over.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it was a crazy football day today because we're going to, no politics, we're talking football and fun stuff.
Oh yeah. It was pretty nutty. We our Aggies were favored to win by a rather sizable margin, and apparently that did not come to pass. We were playing pretty much like I want to say it was the fifth string that was out there. I did not understand. Nobody was clicking with anything. Nobody was.
Are you sure it wasn't more that SEC referees trying to like beat the spread, had some bets on the game, kind of thing?
It could have been, because there was one, for example, there was one play where pass was thrown by Arkansas and the guy catches it and everything, and he caught it like a yard from the spot, I guess, the first down.
Mm-hmm.
And they gave it to him a yard above that.
Free yards. Away. I love the free yards call. Free yards are fun. Aren't they? That's an SEC
that
thing.
I watched it over and over and over, and I was like, I don't know what they're looking at, because that is just not what happened. And
free yards are always fun.
The commentators were saying the same thing. That was a very generous spot. A very generous spot.
Yeah, they, and Georgia had a bye this week, so I'll have to get excited about your team. Unlike LL, your team is actually an SEC team, so I can get excited about talking football with you. But crazy weekend in the SEC. Auburn is beating Mississippi State right now, 42-9, and it's halftime.
Yeah.
Come on, Mississippi State. What the hell is wrong with you?
Yeah, I caught part of that that game earlier, and I was like, this does not fare well.
Yeah.
This doesn't bode well. I did manage to catch the Baylor game with Iowa State.
Uh-huh.
And that one was down to the wire. That really was down to the wire.
Really?
I was not going to lie. I was disappointed that Baylor won, and I'm going to catch flack for it, but I'm not a Baylor fan, so I can say that.
Yeah, no, I wouldn't think so, because that's another Texas team.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Yeah.
So,
Alabama only beat Ole Miss by 4 touchdowns.
Only
4 touchdowns. Well, I mean, Alabama's number 2 and Ole Miss isn't ranked. And so, I mean, you know.
Well, yeah. But I was surprised about Clemson, though. They won by 1 point to an unranked team. And I was just, what?
Tell you what. It is a crazy college football year all around so far. Florida played a nobody, so we're not even going to talk about Florida. really, it's a little late in the season to be playing nobodies like that, but whatever. I think we got another one coming. So, yeah, boring day around here because it was bye week. So I don't really have much to say. I'll be more fun next week.
I bet you will.
You know? Yeah. I mean, I spent Wednesday night on toxic masculinity talking about the Bulldogs, and they let me talk about the Bulldogs. You listened to it, the whole show.
Yeah,
they let me talk nothing but UGA the whole show.
Oh, that was great. I was having a blast listening.
Nobody,
I was like, oh, this is my
Nobody girl. Listens to me talk about Georgia for an hour. Ever. It was awesome.
Well, there's some that let me talk for an hour or so, but it's usually the other voices in my head. They tend to compete, so that's about it.
Yeah, it counts, though. It counts.
It does.
Right?
It does
Yeah,
count.
I will listen to myself for an hour, and that counts.
I have been known to speak to myself, wandering around, especially if I'm at my mother's house, because sometimes she has little projects for me, and then she wants to move furniture. And so I'll be walking around. This is not going to fit here. This will fit here, but I don't know if this is going to look good here. Let's move it around here. And I'll be doing it all by myself. And my father has called me a couple of times. He says to me, are you feeling okay? And I'll tell him, yeah. Nobody listens to me, so I'll talk to myself, and I'll listen to me, and I'll feel good about it. So that's that. Yeah. That's pretty much my...
Well, I usually, it's all directed at the dogs, right? So, so it's like I'm talking to them, but I'm really not, because I mean they can't understand me, they can't answer me. The little one will look at me like she understands me though. She's like she's just appeasing me, I know, but she doesn't understand. It's all like blah 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 booby blah blah blah, but. At least she acts like she knows what I'm saying. It makes me feel better about talking to myself.
Well, my big dog, she's good about it. She will actually look at me as I'm speaking, and she'll cock her head a little, and she'll make some moves like she's nodding her head or not understanding, or she'll lay down or whatever. The little dog, apparently she's starting to lose her hearing, so she doesn't pay attention to me at all, but it's great because I can sneak up on my dog now, and it's fun.
Sometimes I'll try to talk dog to my dog.
I've yet to do that. I've not gone down that road.
I've clearly said too much now. Let's move on to the next topic.
Well, the next topic is probably the one topic that most people were talking about outside of politics, and it was Ivanka Trump's little so-called wardrobe malfunction. And I say so-called because it was not a malfunction at all. There were several pictures taken of her at the UN. She went to hear President Trump speak there, and everything was overshadowed by the fact that her nipples were showing, the not literally showing, but you know, they were, the headlights were on. So everybody was talking about how, you know, how embarrassing this is, and you know, how it's a malfunction. She forgot her bra. And when you look at the pictures that were taken of her outfit, which was fabulous, you can clearly see that she's wearing a bra underneath. So, I mean, it's just, it was cold there and her body reacted. There's no shame in that. I found it really, really sad that there were the same people that bitch and moan and complain about the workplace being too cold and they need to raise the temperature because it's just uncomfortable for us and we get to have nipple hard on, so to speak.
Right.
I can't believe I'm talking about this right now, but it's true.
It is.
You know, right?
I mean, that's... It's the same
people equivalent. That about it.
Yeah, well, it's kind of in the event of, like, if it happens because it's cold, it's kind of the opposite. But it is, you know, it's a similar kind of thing. It's a similar reaction. But, yeah, it was Nipplegate all over the place. And I was like, really? Really, do we not have anything better to do? So, people who believe, they truly, and they I don't believe that they really believe this, but they at least pretend to really believe that a trans woman, which is actually a man, can have a period, or get an abortion. Also believe that it was absolutely scandalous for Ivanka, who is, by the way, a real woman, to show some nipple through a bra and a shirt, and not a thin shirt. It wasn't a see-through shirt. It wasn't a thin shirt. It was a heavy, like, button-down shirt. It's not like she planned it. It certainly, it wasn't a wardrobe malfunction because she was dressed for, you know, air conditioning. Clearly.
She was. And this goes to show that the same people, like I said, the same people that complain about how the workplace is always cold and they need to bring it up, they could have used this as an example to get their point across.
Right, and I think it could be a number of things, right? So there's the obvious she's a Trump, let's look for a reason to make fun of her, right? A reason to criticize her, something to say. And then there's the obvious just, you know, low-class jealousy that happens. Because there's one thing that, and anyone who disputes this is lying or an idiot. There's one thing that you can say about Ivanka, and that is that she never doesn't look fabulous. She is a good-looking girl. She always brings her A game when it comes to her appearance. She never doesn't look well. I think I saw one like mom picture of her where she kind of has a messy bun and she might have even had on yoga pants. She still looked great. She still looked great. She's a beautiful girl. And as far as I'm concerned, as a woman, if you can't admit that, then you're the one with the problem, and I feel sorry for your insecurities, you know?
It's true. Most women, I mean, admittedly, this is inherent to our nature. We are very catty. We are definitely not the delicate sex. We are the violent sex.
Well, I mean, you know, there's a, like, I still have, like, really heavy strains of, like, Viking in me, like, no kidding. My DNA comes back and I'm like, how can I possibly still have this much Scandinavian in me? But I mean, from hundreds of years ago, I thought, evidently not, but I mean, you know, so you don't have to talk to me about warrior women and violent women, because I mean, we were that, like, Viking women were kicking more ass than Viking men, evidently, or as much.
Yes, they were.
And
so, you know, I was just, it always stuns me that they choose something this petty to attack someone. I'm not the type, I try really, really hard not to criticize anybody based on looks, because I'm not one that has the looks to, you know, be proud of or anything. I mean, I'm okay.
You're adorable. Stop it, Aggie. You're adorable.
I don't want somebody to do that to me. So why would I do that to somebody else?
I will reciprocate. Right? I will certainly reciprocate with someone who throws it at me, or more so my friends, right? So if somebody has something to say about one of my friends, I might throw it back at them. I might reciprocate.
Exactly. Yeah. It has to be thrown first before I get...
Typically. I'm just not that. And I'm not the most secure person in the world either. So I think you have to be a really insecure, really catty person to do that. But then again, it happens so much. I hate to think that there's that many catty plus that insecure people out there. Maybe it's just common. I wasn't raised like that.
Could be.
My mama didn't raise me like that. But
No, I have. I'm proud to say I have very beautiful sisters, and we kind of look alike if we stand close together, but apart we don't look anything alike. So it's really cool when we all get together. People are like, "Oh, you really are sisters."
Right.
It's hilarious to me. I literally have one of my sisters was actually. She entered a contest for 17 magazine when we were really, really young, and she got beat out by Kathy Ireland. So it should tell you, I got pretty sisters.
Yeah. So, yeah, that's really pretty cool.
But it saddens me that, you know, you can't, you know, appreciate somebody's beauty regardless of the politics. It has become so politicized that it's gotten really icky. So...
That was pretty low. Alice is in the chat room. He said, "Ivanka's nipples made my day."
They made a lot of men's day.
Yeah, exactly. And hey, when you said you wanted to talk about it, I went back to look it up to see, and I found one article, and it was all men, like, dissing her about her nipples. I was like, are y'all gay? Right? I mean, I was like, that's just stupid. Right? Are y'all gay? Not that there's anything wrong with that. But yeah, so anywho.
Alrighty.
Yeah.
This is taking a turn.
Yeah, you know, my conversations with me usually do, but yeah, so, but I was surprised by that. I was surprised at how many men were, like, dissing her about her nipples. I was like, anybody else, and it, you would have loved it, so whatever.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you know that. You definitely know that. Had it been Scarlett Johansson, had it been, you know, some other babe like that, oh, they'd be all over that, thinking that was a gift to mankind, you know.
Yeah, absolutely. Even at the UN, Scarlett Johansson or, you know, Jessica
Angelina
Alba.
You know, any of those that have actually been at the UN and spoken, you would think.
I will say this, that they were looking kind of large, so I'm wondering if she's pregnant again.
Ooh, I do wonder.
Yeah.
They were impressive.
Yeah, I mean, they, like, I don't remember them being that large, not that I looked that close, right? And maybe that's what it was. I was looking closer than usual, but they looked pretty large, so I was like, I wonder if she's preggers. That was the first thing that came to my mind.
I didn't even think about that, but, you know, that's a possibility. I mean, it does happen.
My mind works in weird ways sometimes, Aggie.
And that's okay, and that's why we love you.
Right? Among other reasons.
Yep.
Yeah.
So, anyway. But that was pretty much the scandal du jour for the week. Or du... I forget the word for week in French, but whatever. Yeah, the scandal of the week. Some interesting news that...
You made me forget it, too. And usually that's one that I can come up with, but whatever.
Yeah, I forgot. Tasha? No. You know what? Forget it. This is not French class, so I'm not going to worry about it.
Yeah, yay.
But another thing that I noticed this week that came out was the news that Amazon is going to have an Echo glasses. And that kind of threw me for a loop because I didn't think that's a great idea. I mean, from a security point of view.
No, it's not. It's not. And the one thing is that everything, you know me, the harbinger of doom, everything like that is vulnerable. It all can be exploited. So if it's got, if it connects with, it connects to the internet, it's vulnerable. It will be vulnerable. It is vulnerable. It can be vulnerable. It can get owned. So there's that. And then the other thing is both Google and Amazon have been caught, as well as Microsoft, who may very well be listening in on this Skype conversation.
Oh, that's true.
And Facebook. All of them have been caught listening in on the conversations that we have, listening into what, you know, people are saying. And Amazon and Google were both caught listening to conversations that people are just having, right? So if you have it in your house and you're having conversations in your house, that's bad enough. But now you're taking it with you when you leave the house, and it's hearing all the conversations that you have throughout the day.
That is, to me, so... That's beyond creepy, in my opinion.
Yeah.
It really is. I don't own a listening device, Google or Amazon.
A spy device? Right.
Well, first of all, I'm a tech noob. Let's just get that one out of the way. But even if I were really tech savvy, I wouldn't feel comfortable having that in my house. It's programmed to keep listening for its, you know, for to hear its name so it can, like, turn on and stuff. So
right.
I that feels icky.
Well, you know me, I know my way around the internet.
Yeah.
I would not have one, and that's why I wouldn't have one in my house. I have a I do have some smart devices. I'm not even comfortable saying on air what I have in my house, right? I mean, surely everybody knows I have a smartphone. That's bad enough. It's just, you open yourself up to being exploited, being targeted when you do things, when you have things like that. I understand people love them. They have them. They love them. You know, they make life easier. I even know, like, one of my, I won't call her a hero, but she's someone that I respect a lot in the digital forensics world. She's really good at what she does, and she's a speaker and a teacher, and really, really good. But she has, I mean, she talks about Alexa forensics and the Alexa in her house, and I'm like, I can't believe you have one of those things. I just can't believe it, right? Of all the people, someone who does forensics on them and knows what you can find when you get into one, knows the criminal cases that have been closed based on, you know, well, it, you killed that person and it Alexa recorded it, right? So we've got the struggle right here, right, Lisa? We can hear you killing them because it's on your Alexa. And she has one in her house anyway, so I think it's, that's really interesting to me. But you know, it's just, our devices make us really smart. They also make us vulnerable, and we have to be careful. But the big thing is that Amazon listens to you, right? So Google tracks you, and Amazon tracks you, and Facebook tracks you, and they all get together and track you and share it.
Yeah.
So
and it's kind of weird because as a society, we tend to value that whole right to privacy thing a lot more than other places where I've lived. And for me, this is like a total, it's tone deafness to it.
Yeah, it is. There's the early adopter phenomenon. I think they're, you know, having the new gadget is really cool. And I mean, you know, I've been there. I certainly care, understand it more and care more about it than I did at one point in my life. Still cleaning up some old accounts that, you know, that are out there that, you know, I created, like, stupid social media accounts, Foursquare accounts and stuff like that. And still cleaning up some of that stuff because I just, you know, just didn't think about it. I mean, there was a time that I loved Google. I thought that Google was great. And they used to be better than they are, but they've always been. You know, the plan was always to collect all the data, you know, and make it a commodity.
Yeah.
So, you know,
they just wanted to do a friendly face, I suppose.
Yeah, yeah. Back to the glasses. It is a, it is, you know, the engineers that created them, you know, should be proud, I suppose, right? And they're a great invention, and I'm sure they will be popular.
Well, I remember that Google had made some, and they were used, you know, for surgeons used them, and you know, for high tech surgeries and stuff like that. And they raved about them; they thought it was great and everything. But when you're out, you know, walking around wearing those, you know, you're actually doing a POV filmmaking type of thing, and then, you know, you're not getting anybody else's permission to do this, and therefore you're actually invading their privacy. And it didn't go over very well after that, even though they've had it for a while. And from what I can see, it's not a very popular item to have, because people get upset if they see them. And there have been, you know, stores and other places that say you cannot come in here with Google Glass. Straight off, they have that. And So
finding
my face feature and things like that, that just, those are really big red flags for me. And I can't understand why Amazon would think, oh, well, let's do it too. But I guess it's because it is a big red flag. That's why they're doing it. They're collecting data, as you said. So,
Well, inevitably, you know, someone will be saved because of them, right? I mean, you know, or someone's murder will be solved, or some missing person there won't be missing because of them or something. I mean, that's kind of where I hope this it ends up. I don't know of a case of Google Glasses saving anyone's life, though, or solving a murder.
No, I didn't find a single one.
So I don't know what the point. If they can't solve a murder, I don't know what the point is.
This is true. And if it were for this type of thing, and for the express purpose of, you know, police officers and forensics, you know, taking stock of a crime scene and everything so they can review it later, I can understand using that, but it just wigs me out too much. It's too weird.
Yeah, it is kind of wiggy.
Let's face it, I'm so old-fashioned, I still dress like June Cleaver, so there's that.
There is nothing wrong with June Cleaver. So, but I think that's a great, like, segue to a break. What do you think?
Okay.
Okay, well, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back. Oh, yeah, when I get over to the board and get to where I need to be to take a break. Now we're going to take a break. We'll be right back.
Okay.
Flexibility he needed while he was in a tent in Iraq. Grantham University. Turns out that Grantham's been delivering affordable, relevant college and advanced degrees for over 65 years. Heck, if they can deliver a quality education to a soldier in a tent overseas, think about the flexibility Grantham can offer you so you can earn your degree too. It doesn't matter how complicated or full your life is, if getting a degree is on your bucket list, you'll want to do what my son did. You'll want to call Grantham. Find out how easy it is to get started on your education so you can check that college degree off your bucket list. Call Grantham right now. 800-910-1370. That's 800-910-1370. Flexible, affordable, relevant. Call 800-910-1370.
Tired of paying outrageous prices for Viagra? Well, we have great news for you. Now you can finally get Viagra at huge discounts. Healthy Man allows you to save up to $500 on Viagra. Why pay U.S. pharmacy prices of $15 per pill or more when you can get Viagra for less than $3 a pill? Call today and get 40 Viagra pills for only $99. This can cost as much as $600 at your local pharmacy. You can't afford not to call us. If you want Viagra at the lowest prices, never pay $15 a pill pharmacy prices again. Get Viagra for less than $3 a pill. Call 1-800-516-7602 today and save up to $500 and get 40 pills for just $99. Healthy Man is fast, easy, and affordable. Operators are waiting at 1-800-516-7602 to take your call right now. Call 1-800-516-7602. That's 1-800-516-7602. Again, 1-800-516-7602.
Attention business owners and independent contractors. This is a money-saving message from Tax Mediation Services. If your business owes $20,000 or more in taxes, we can help you today, right now. Listen, dealing with the IRS is no picnic. It's an intimidating and extremely stressful process, and you don't want to go it alone. Our attorneys know every law, every tax break, and every possible opportunity to help you resolve and reduce your tax debt. And if you owe more than $20,000, you may be at the top of their hit list. So don't take your tax debt lightly, because it will not go away on its own. The IRS can seize your bank accounts, your home, and even shut down your business. Call our tax experts today at 1-800-783-0810 and let us deal with the IRS while you focus on your business. That's 1-800-783-0810. Again, that's 800-783-0810.
Well, you think you pull your boots on right and wear your hat so well. So pardon me, my laughter, as I sure do understand. Even Moses got excited when he saw the promised land. That's right.
Well, one of the things I wanted to talk about, I'm one of those freaks that likes to start their Christmas shopping early. And by early, I mean I'm usually 2 years ahead of everybody else. So I get that from my mother. And this year, I've fallen a little behind and kind of just, I was phoning it in, basically. And one of the things that I wanted to do was look into subscription boxes, because that's a gift that you can get that keeps giving year round. And I thought that that would be kind of cool for, you know, I have three sisters and a brother, and I thought that'd be kind of a neat thing to do for Christmas instead of getting them something, you know, like a vase or a flashlight or, you know, something they just won't use or regift or whatever. But yeah. Yeah. Really? Oh. I don't think it's Puerto Rican. I don't ever recall that, but it could be an like an infusion of different cultures that came up with this. I don't Yeah. Well, I found it appears that everybody has a subscription for something. There's a subscription for almost everything. And I love the food and drink ones because you can subscribe to a wine box. They send you these test tubes full of wine for you to try. And which, you know, hey, I'm on board with. And there's there's another one called Shaker and Spoon. It's a full 5 ounces per test tube, so it's a full glass. Technically, it's a glass of wine per test tube. So, it's pretty cool. Some of my wine glasses hold 22 ounces, and I am not ashamed of that fact. So, there were others like some that are artisan in nature. One's called California Found, and it's products and made in California by artisans and stuff like that. And one called Globe Inn, which is fair trade items from all over the world. And these are subscription boxes, and you know, you subscribe for a certain amount of money a month or every 3 months, however often they send you the box. And for example, the Globe Inn one will have they'll have a scarf in it, they'll have a mug made from local clay, they'll have handmade paper. It's just different things. It's really, really cool. And you know, that was one that I was thinking about doing for my sister, who loves things from around the world. She loves to collect things from all over, and I thought that would be kind of cool. But, you know, the ones that we always gravitate to are the beauty boxes, which are absolutely fabulous because you're like, wee, I got new makeup, or I got new perfume, or I got new this, or whatever. And some of the more popular ones are like Ipsy and Birchbox. Allure has a beauty box that's really, really good, apparently. And one of the most popular ones right now is FabFitFun. And J.R. Homestead, one of our gals, has that. And she just raves about it because it comes with not only makeup or and skincare, but products for, you know, fitness and for your health, and it's just very well rounded. And she absolutely raves on that one. So
yeah, you know what I did, Aggie? Mm-hmm. The whole time I was talking, I had my mic on the deck. I had it muted. So I'm gonna repeat what I said. Just a little bit of it. I'm going to shorten it a little bit. But what I said was, I do HelloFresh. And I absolutely love HelloFresh. It has opened my mind into cooking different things. So the food is really good. It's all fresh. A lot of it is organic, which, you know, I don't care about that much, but it's really good food. But it's taught me to make things that I wouldn't necessarily make, and My favorite one is lime crema, which is sour cream and lime juice that you put on, like, burrito bowls or tacos or whatever. And the other thing you missed me saying is that I'm the queen of the burrito bowls. I absolutely love them. They're gluten-free. They're yummy. Roasted, the other thing that I learned to make that I never would have thought of that's really great in a burrito bowl is roasted corn. They call it Mexican street corn. And it's really easy to make. Throw it in the pan and just brown it. And, you know, it's really easy. So, on top of, you know, getting me good fresh food and making me cook it once or twice a week, they, you know, they've also opened my mind into cooking new things. And I cook more, and my food is more interesting, and I eat better. So, it's been great. HelloFresh has been great for me.
Well, that's definitely one that I want to try. I know my brother and his wife, obviously my sister-in-law, they love to cook together. So that's something that I would definitely see me gifting them for Christmas, you know. For my youngest sister, it's something that would probably never get used because she's allergic to the kitchen. So, you know, so whatever.
Yeah, you know, I was really sporadic about cooking and not regular about it and not really great about what I ate, especially living alone. You know, it's just me, and it's hard to justify, like, cooking a whole meal for yourself. So, it was really good for me from that perspective. But I want to try beauty products or something like that and see if they'll open my mind to new things that I wouldn't have tried.
I'm like you. I'm like a creature of habit, and sometimes it's really hard for me to let go of something that I have been using for years, beauty-wise, I might add. And like the other, you know, just a few weeks ago, I went out and I was at an antique mall, and I smelled the airspun powder from Coty, and I was like, oh, I can't believe this is taking me back, because I used to use it when I was little in my grandmother's house. So guess what? I went and bought some. So I mean, talk about habit reestablished. But yeah, this would actually force me out of my comfort zone and allow me to try other stuff and see if it works better than what I currently have, or work worse. But at least, you know, it's a trial size, so you're not actually paying for a full-size product and then not being able to return it or letting it go to waste.
Right, yeah, that's the other thing. Well, and I have two sisters here in town, so if I buy something and I don't like it, I can usually find somebody to give it away,
definitely. My sister lives up the street,
she
takes discards all the time. So, but, yeah, one of the things that I did find when I was researching them, that they have, like, really high-end beauty boxes. And, you know, like, from designers and stuff. And they tend to be really pricey, but some of the stuff that you get in there, you know, like a $200 purse, stuff like that. I'm like, maybe I'll put that on my Christmas list.
Right, yeah. That's what I'm thinking with, you know, with any box like that. You're bound to get, like, the occasional random treasure, right? We've got four, and I'm laughing because we've got four guys in the chat room that are probably, like, going, what are we listening to? But, you know, they're saying, a couple of them are saying that it sucks to cook for one. I'll just tell you guys that HelloFresh has made it more fun to cook just for myself. Now, and I have my dad over sometimes, but, you know, most of the time I'm cooking just for myself, and that, you know, trying new things and things that I wouldn't necessarily try, unless you're a picky eater and you just like to stick to what you like to stick to, because I've known those people and there's nothing wrong with that. But, you know, if that's not, you know, how you are, if you don't like to branch out or if you do like to branch out and try new things, and, you know, you just, like, going to the store and buying, like, enough groceries to feed an army just isn't your thing, because that was, you know, that's what would happen a lot. Recipes are like for 4 and 6 and 8 people.
Right.
And you buy a, just for instance, a bundle of cilantro. I can't get through a tenth of that before it goes bad. Right.
We use cilantro all the time, and I still can't go through an entire bunch. And I don't care if it's only 68 cents. The point is, it goes to waste.
Yes. Yeah, absolutely. Well, you know, HelloFresh sends you just enough to make the recipe. So, you know, it's, and I get 2 meals out of it, right? But it's just 2 meals. So I'm not freezing 6 containers. I am, you know, putting 1 container in the freezer and eating it the next day. Well, sometimes with me, it's 3 meals, but still, it's not, I'm not freezing 6 containers of something. So, you know, it's just enough to make the recipe. It's at most 3 meals for me, but it's 3 good meals. So I can do 2 a week. And the thing about HelloFresh is if you subscribe and you want to skip, I mean, I'll skip 2, 3, 4 weeks in a row just because I get burnt out on it, right? So if I get burnt out on it, I just skip a few weeks. And by the time the next one comes, I'm excited to have it again. And I'm not, like, spending money that I'm throwing away or that, you know, I'm not, like, stoked to have the food or something like that. So it can be, I'm an advocate of, what do you say?
HelloFresh.
Yeah. That, are they making fun of my accent? It's HelloFresh. HelloFresh. There's another one that's a food one too. I don't know what it is. Do you know what the name of it is?
Blue Apron.
Okay. One. That wasn't the one I was thinking of. I know that there's a few of them. HelloFresh. Yeah. I don't know if you can, like, if there's the flexibility, you can do just, like, I do 2 meals for 2 a week. And, like I said, I'll skip 3 or 4 weeks in a row. And that's a lot of flexibility, right? So every month I'm not spending tons of money on it.
Oh, yeah. Home Chef and Blue Apron. Yeah, those are good. And I think I like one of the things that you mentioned, they come with a recipe, which you can use later. You know, if you feel like buying the, you know, going to the store and buying the ingredients for that one and, you know, doing it on your own, not relying on the package to send you the same stuff again. So that's pretty cool.
Yeah, absolutely. So, yeah. So, I mean, I'm an advocate of that. It's been good for me. But I want to try one of the beauty boxes. I'm going to do that one day. Tell me about that toilet.
Oh, the toilet. We were supposed to talk about the toilet last week, and we totally forgot because Brad and I were having so much fun with the cocktails. There's a shock.
Oh yeah, I'm so surprised.
No, it was the weirdest thing. I don't know if a lot of people are familiar with this, but Blenheim Palace was the home of Winston Churchill, and it's a UNESCO site. It's a museum now, and an Italian artist actually made a solid gold, not a golden, but a solid gold working toilet. And it's an actual working toilet as an art installation inside Blenheim Palace. And the name of the toilet is America, which, considering what's going on nowadays, it's apt.
Yes, a solid gold toilet is very apropos, I think. A solid gold toilet called America.
Yeah.
It fits.
Yeah, it does. And it was a working toilet. I mean, people used it. You could use this toilet.
Of course, it wouldn't be quite as apropos.
Apparently, someone decided they needed this toilet. I want to say about 2 weeks ago, it was stolen.
You're sweet, Ron. That's sweet, Ron.
And they broke in and they stole this toilet. And authorities figured there were two vehicles. They don't say if it were two trucks or two, you know, hyped up Italian job style type of cars or whatever. But
maybe it was a construction claw, like the one that took the ATM out of the building in Russia.
It could be. I mean, these people broke in overnight, and it took them a while to, which really begs the question. It took them that long because they didn't leave until about almost 5 o'clock in the morning with this toilet. And I'm wondering, I know the whole place is an art museum, so they had to have had an insider doing the whole security thing. And it's just like somebody's got a gold toilet now.
They melted that. See, that's the sad part is that it's probably already melted down by now. Ron says, and you guys are sweet in the chat room. Thank you. And then Ron said, and I have absolutely no comment on that, on beauty products or filters and whether or not I need them. Yeah, right, especially the filter part. Yeah, so Ron says, I want one of those Japanese toilets with the blast of clean air, and it has lights and music. Only the Japanese, right?
It's always the Japanese.
Only the Japanese would do, like, the lights and music on the toilet.
Oh, yeah.
That's great.
Japan got a Japan.
Everybody should be able to train their dogs like the Japanese can train their dogs, though.
Oh, that is true. They do a very good job.
All of the amazing dog videos that have dogs doing things that you never thought dogs could do, and they're always almost always golden retrievers, they're always Japanese. You notice that?
Yeah.
Always Japanese. I mean, they sit at the table, they say their prayers, they eat with forks. I've never seen such.
Japan is a very unique culture. It's lovely in many aspects, it's creepy in many aspects, and it's totally baffling in almost all of them, so.
Yep, and I can't get my dog to stop stealing my jeans. And my shoes. She destroys my shoes. Yeah.
That is too cute. But we love them, and we couldn't do without them. That is true.
Jeff says he's surprised that they don't have a scoreboard. Yeah, Jeff is surprised that they don't have a scoreboard for various activities while on the toilet.
Jeff, do not give them any ideas for a new game show.
No, dude. Japanese game show. Yep, absolutely. Absolutely. Yes. Well, this is the second show this week that I've done where pooping was a topic.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry.
Yeah, don't be sorry. It's awesome. Pooping should always be a topic on every show.
Well, maybe not.
Yeah. Aggie, can you believe we just did a whole hour?
I am shocked because I did not have a lot to talk about. But
we did. Evidently, we had a lot more than, well, me having to repeat things because I was dead air there for a minute. But, anyway, so where are you at on Twitter?
I am at Aggie Regan on Twitter, and that's pretty much it.
Yeah, I am Cyber Wars Podcast. I'm here every other Sunday night. Tomorrow night we won't be on. We just did 2 weeks in a row, so we're taking a break. And I'm also on the Red Wine on Wednesdays. Both are at 9 p.m. on KLRN Radio. And say goodnight, Aggie.
Good night.
Good night. Thank you.
Don't let the bed bugs bite.
And thanks you guys for joining us. Thanks for being in the chat room. We love all four of y'all. Unless it's four or five of y'all. We love y'all. We'll see you soon.
Good night, everybody.
Good night.
You say you're not from Texas. Man, as if I couldn't tell. Well, you think you pull your boots on right and wear your hat so well. So pardon me, my laughter, as I sure do understand. Even Moses got excited when he saw the promised land. That's right, you're not Texas. That's right, you're not Texas. That's right.